Pakistan has a desire to change its ways and get off America's blacklist of countries violating religious freedom. That's according to a top U.S. diplomat, Sam Brownback. He's in the Middle East, meeting with foreign representatives about how their countries can better protect people of different faiths, including Christians. Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reports from the State Department. Good evening, Wyatt.
Good evening, Lauren. The ambassador at large for international freedom says he's been talking with Pakistan's foreign minister, who is promising to appoint a person to handle all U.S. concerns. Right now, Pakistan is one of the world's most dangerous places for Christians to practice their faith, largely because of blasphemy laws that carry a death sentence even for criticizing Islam. Now, Pakistan is just one of several countries Sam Brownback is talking about this week. He's also voicing concerns about Sudan in Africa and a couple of Gulf states, Saudi Arabia and the UAE. However, he says both the UAE and Saudi Arabia have taken steps to promote the right to choose one's faith. He spoke in particular about the new Saudi leadership's approach.
They've got a long ways to go. They have made some steps, though, that I think are promising, and the comments out of the leadership are different now than you have ever heard, that I have heard in decades, if ever, coming out of the Saudi leadership.
Brownback has been meeting with diplomats in the UAE after he traveled to Pakistan. Many of the countries he's talking about, including Saudi Arabia and Pakistan, are designated by the State Department as countries of particular concern. That means those countries have engaged in or at least tolerated ongoing violations of religious freedom. Now, Brownback also thanked the UAE for hosting Pope Francis earlier this month. The Holy Father's visit and the Papal Mass were both first of its kind for the Arabian Peninsula. Sam Brownback also converted to Catholicism in 2002. Lauren?
Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reporting from the State Department. Thank you, Wyatt.